Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create labels in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. What is a label? Well, I'm glad you asked that question. It's an area widget that holds text and or an image within a window. So to begin, we'll need to create a window to act as a container to hold this label. We can create a window with window equals tk followed by window.mainloop, and this will give us a window in which we can add a label to. Now let's give our label a unique name, such as label, and in order to instantiate a label, we'll follow this label name with equals label with a capital L and a set of parentheses. The parentheses are acting as the constructor for this widget, our label, and we can pass in arguments into these parentheses. The first argument that we're going to pass in is a master, the container for this label. We're going to pass in the name of our window because our window is acting as the container. With widgets in Python, we can delimit the arguments that we're passing in with a comma, and there are options available to us. Options are keyword arguments that we can pass in to the constructor for this widget. One option available to us is text, and we can set the text of this label equal to a string that we set. So let's say that we want this label to say, "Hello world." Well, we're going to pass in this option, text, and it's a keyword argument. So if we were to do this, we're going to set the text of the label, but this label currently doesn't appear within our window. What gives, bro? I thought you knew how to code. Hold up. Wait a minute. There's one more thing that we need to do. So we're going to actually add this label to the window now. We set the master of the label to be our window, but now we actually have to add it as step two. One way in which we can do that is to use a pack function of our label. So follow label equals label and pass in all of your arguments, and then follow this with the name of the label dot pack. So with the pack option, by default, this will place our widget in the top center of our window. Another way in which we can add a label to a container or window is to use the place function, and we can set some coordinates of where we want this label or other widget to appear within the window. If we want this to appear in the top left corner, we can set x to equal 0 and y to equal 0, and these are options available to us too that we can pass in. So this place function will place our label at some position or some set of coordinates within the window, and with x equals 0 and y equals 0, that will place our widget in the top left corner of the window. And if I were to change these to, let's say, x equals 100 and y equals 100, well, this is going to be placed down by 100 pixels and to the right by 100 pixels. So you can use pack or place. There's a few others like grid, but they're a little more complex, so we'll get to that in a future video. For the time being, I'm going to use the pack function of the label and turn this place function into a comment, label.pack. All right, now, how can we customize this label? We can pass in different options when we instantiate this label. Let's change the font, and that's another option. We can change the font with font equals, and then we can pass in a font. Let's begin with a font family. I will say maybe Arial, a size, perhaps 40, and then a style if you so choose, like bold. There's also italic and underline, but this will work just fine then. So this will change the font of the text of our label, and it says hello world still. Now let's change the foreground color. So that is another option. The foreground is the font color, and the option is FG for foreground. It's short for foreground. Foreground equals, we can state a color name such as green, and our text should now be green. You can select something more specific by passing in a hex value. So a custom color that I like is hashtag 00FF00. This is bright green. You can always look up what different hex values are. And we can also change the background color too. That is BG, short for background color, and we can pass in a color name or a hex value. I'm just going to set this to black, just to demonstrate that we can pass in both either hex values or color names. And what we have is green text on a black background. And this is the limits of our label within the window, because when we expand this window, the label is still going to stay the same size. If we were to change the text within the label, our label is only going to take up the room that it needs. And you can see that our label is now smaller. Now we have all of these arguments within our constructor, and it's getting a little bit difficult to actually read. So I'm going to separate each of these arguments line by line just so that this is more organized, but it'll work just the same as it did before. Now, how do we add a border around our label? One, we can set the border style with the relief option, and one border that I like is raised. But right now, the border width is 1, so it's a little difficult for us to actually see the border. Let's increase the border width with the option BD, and I'll set this equal to maybe 10. So this border is now more visible. Another relief, which is the border style, is sunken. And this will give our label a sunken appearance, but I think I'll change this back to raised. We can also add some padding around the text, between the text and the border. We can pad X and pad Y. Pad X will add some padding, some space between the X-axis of our text between the border. So let's set this to maybe 20, and we now have 20 pixels worth of space between the text and the border. Let's also pad Y. This will add some space above and below our text between the text and the border. Now, how do we add an image to a label? We first need to create what's called a photo image, and we will create this within the lines of window equals tk and window.mainloop. And let's give this photo image a unique name, like photo. And in order to create a photo image, we're going to follow this with photo equals photo image. And within the constructor of our photo image, there's an option called file, and we can list a file path or a file name. Right now on my desktop, there is an image that I want to use, and I need to convert this to a photo image. Here's my desktop, and this is an image that I want to use to add to my label. I need to get the file path, and I can get that by going to properties. Then underneath location, I can copy this location address and paste it within the quotes for file. And then I need to add the image name, and this is person.png. And with these backslashes, these need to be double backslashes because that is the escape character for a backslash. But what would be a better option is to add this image to my project folder that contains the Python file that I'm working with. So in place of listing the entire file path, I'm going to copy the image that I want to use, go to my project folder, and then paste it. And I no longer need this entire file path. I can just list the image name that I have. And now what we need to do is add this photo to the label, and there is an option to do so. That is the image option, and we'll place this within the constructor for the label. We're going to set image equal to the photo image that we have, and our photo image is called photo. This will add our photo image to our label, or other widget depending on what we're working with. So we have our image, but it replaced all of the text that we had for this label. How do we add both text and an image to a window? Well, we can follow this with the compound option. We can set a direction of where we want this image to be placed relative to the text that we have. So I'm going to set compound equal to bottom so that the image appears on the bottom or underneath our text. So we can both have text and an image. Or if I want this to be in a different location, I could set this to maybe top, left, or right. If I were to set this to top, we have our image on top of our text. And one thing to know about labels and many other widgets in Python is that the size of the widget will actually increase to accommodate the size of all the components that's contained within. If I were to give the text a longer string of characters, such as, bro, do you even code? Then the width of our label is actually going to expand to accommodate the size of the longer string of text that we have. So that's the basics of labels, everyone. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of labels in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me. help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.